My Lime. Brought to you by Kellogg's, the folks who bring the best to you each morning. The widest choice of cereals in the forms you like best. Yours from Kellogg's of Battle Creek. Now let's all play What's My Line?
And now, tonight, starting their 11th year on the air, here is the award-winning panel of What's My Line. First, the popular columnist whose voice of Broadway appears in papers coast to coast, Miss Dorothy Kilgallen.
Last night, the famous theatrical club called The Lands gave a testimonial dinner to an actor whom I consider, and I don't think anyone will contradict me, the greatest player of Gilbert and Sullivan in our time. And I'm very proud that he's sitting here on my left, Mr. Martin Green.
Thank you, Dorothy. And it's my great pleasure to introduce somebody whom you all know, who performed on Broadway in Once More With Feeling, The Home Show, and someone I'm very, very fond of indeed, Miss Arlene Francis.
And now sitting in for our dear vacationing Bennett Cerf is my own particular actor-producer, dear Martin Gable.
Across the floor, one of the most articulate men in television, Mr. John Daly.
By reason of this chair, it falls to my happy luck to be, in a way, a spokesman for all of my colleagues on the panel, those who have with us tonight and those who have been with us through the years. I think many of you know that this is our 10th anniversary, our 500th broadcast. We began way back on February 2nd, 1950. And if you think about it, as all of us have, we feel that if it really is an anniversary and it calls for a celebration, we should give a party for all of you, because we should certainly not be here on this 10th anniversary if it wasn't for the support and affection we've had from our public. Thank you very much. And now I think it's only fair to tell Mr. Green that all these kind words don't mean a thing. We're going to get the panel tonight again if we possibly can. So welcome once more to What's My Line. And we'll be up to our old tricks very shortly. We'll also have a famous mystery guest before the panel a little bit later in the show. And we'll meet our first challenger after this word from Dennis James speaking for Kellogg's. And now let's meet our first challenger. Would you come in and sign in, please? Don L. Brown, right, sir? Where are you from, Mr. Brown?
I'm from Denver, Colorado, Mr. Daly.
Denver, Colorado.
That's right.
Well, that's a nice country to be from.
Thank you.
And I don't mean it the way it sounded, the old joke. I mean it's a nice country in which to live. And it's nice to have you with us. May I present the panel, Mr. Brown?
Thank you.
Brown's panel, will you join me over here? Do you know how we keep score, Mr. Brown?
Yes, sir.
In that event, let's let the good audience here in the theater and those who are watching at home know exactly what your line is. Well, panel, we'll tell you that Mr. Brown is salaried, and let's begin the general questioning with Arlene Francis.
Well, Mr. Brown looks like a distinguished gentleman. Do you work for a non-profit making organization, Mr. Brown?
Yes.
That's pretty distinguished. Do you represent any branch of our government?
No.
That's not very distinguished. That's one down and nine to go, Mr. Gable.
You work for a university, Mr. Brown?
Yes.
Is your job with the university require you to be outdoors often?
Sometimes.
Would you be in the general category of teacher at the university?
Yes.
Do you teach a non-academic subject?
Sometimes.
I don't know where I'm going, but I'm going.
You're going. But good, too,
Mark. Have you? Well, Mr. Brown's general, he looks like a clean-cut American university man.
Well, thank you.
Not talking about it. Have you anything to do with sports?
Yes.
Is your sport a seasonal sport?
No.
That's 2 down and 8 to go, Miss Kilgallen.
Well, aside from the sport, Mr. Brown, do you teach something academic?
Sometimes.
Well, are we guessing the sometimes or the other?
Well, actually, what you get to hear is that sometimes is a perfectly valid answer, and you will have to assume that there could be an academic cast to his overall responsibility.
I see. Are you...
I told you he was articulate, Dorothy.
I've known it for some years, John.
Thank you, Bob.
Mr. Brown, is your work mental as well as physical?
Yes, ma'am.
Is it physical as well as mental?
Yes, ma'am.
Can the sport that you have some connection with be played indoors as well as outdoors?
Yes, ma'am.
Are implements used?
Sometimes.
Knives, guns, things like that.
Well, do you teach more, or are you connected with more than one sport?
Yes, ma'am.
Oh. Are you the head of a department?
Yes, ma'am.
Are you the head of the athletic department?
Yes, ma'am.
Medical education.
Actually, I'm going to throw these all over. I'm mad on the 500th broadcast. I think Mr. Brown will agree that you're so close now that it would be a little bit unfair to make them go to director
well,
of physical education.
I don't mind keeping on.
Well, that, you've got, actually, Martin, you started off brilliantly, and Dorothy has revealed it's director of physical education. At Loretto Heights College in Denver.
Right.
Mr. Brown was very generous to you because he actually is connected with Loretto Heights College and on a technicality could have ruled out the university issue, I think.
Excuse me, but isn't Loretto Heights a girls' school?
It sure is. Thank you very much, Dorothy. That was our little surprise. We never got a chance to spring it. And I wonder... if you have any words of wisdom to give us when you have this assignment as director of physical education at a girls' school, I think you could help us out. We all have problems with girls.
Watch yourselves at all times.
You know?
Well, I can say, Mr. Daly, we don't have our problems in our school, but we do enjoy the work with the girls.
Girls have trouble concentrating, no doubt.
How's your football team?
We don't have a football
team. You don't have a football team? Now, I think this is wonderful. Actually, Mr. Brown has got a degree in physical education. You also, I think, are studying for even more credits and acclaim in the field of physiology.
I'm laboring on a master's.
You're laboring on
this
it.
Time.
But he's happy, and we understand from the young ladies at Loretto Heights that they're happy, and everybody is much healthier than they've ever been before, so a great good has been achieved.
We're happy.
And you've been very good to join us in What's My Line. Thank you. Well, I must congratulate you, panel. That's a very brilliant beginning. Let's see what you've